If you're interested in the basics of ISO 42001, the AI governance standard, then this video is for you. So I'll explain you some very basic information like who has published it, also which companies can implement this kind of standard, also what are the main benefits of implementing such a standard, but also how does this AI governance work? So how do you actually decide what kind of AI safeguards you have to implement as part of this standard? And I'll also show you where to find a free online course to learn more details about ISO 42001. So after you watch this video, you'll have a clear idea on what is the purpose of ISO 42001 and why it is actually a leading AI governance standard. Okay, let's start with some basics. So the full title of this standard is ISO/IEC 42001-2023 Information Technology Artificial Intelligence Management Systems. So quite a lengthy title, but let me explain all these details. ISO stands for ISO organization, so basically the organization that has published this standard. And this ISO organization is an international organization that was founded by governments around the world, and each standard is published by a consent from all of these governments. So this is basically why this ISO 42001 is accepted in every country of the world. 2023 means that this standard was published in that year, and by the way, it was published in December 2023, so this was basically 1 year after the initial launch of ChatGPT, so you could say 1 year after this ground zero of this new era of AI technology. And this artificial intelligence management systems means that the main purpose of this standard is to describe how to manage AI systems, or in other words, how to set up AI governance in a systematic way. Now, this standard is not mandatory, at least not yet, but it can basically be implemented by any company that wants to prove to its customers or other third parties that it can manage its AI systems in a trustworthy way. So it's not true that it can be implemented only by large companies that develop these large language models. It can be actually implemented by any company that develops its, let's say, AI-based applications, but also by companies that only use AI systems from third parties. And it's a good thing that companies can get certified against ISO 42001, and this means that an independent certification body issues a certificate which then proves to actually customers and all the other interested parties that this company governs its AI in the best possible way. And just to mention that individuals can also certify against ISO 42001 by going for some courses and then passing a certification exam. And later on in the video, I'll show you one such course. Now, how does this AI governance work according to ISO 42001? What is the main principle? Well, the main principle is that actually companies need to assess the risks related to AI systems, and then they have to apply appropriate controls to decrease those risks. So let me give you an example. Let's say a company is developing AI systems that are used for answering customer tickets. Now, the risk with such systems could be that AI simply hallucinates. In other words, that provides wrong information to a user. Now, you can apply several controls to decrease those risks. For example, first of all, you can actually control what kind of training data you're using and make sure only the reliable answers are included in this training data. You could use some kind of output validity checks so that you have potentially some other AI system that is checking actually the output from the previous AI system in order to make sure that actually these outputs are correct. Or you could simply have a human in the loop. So whenever you have some kind of, let's say, sensitive information being communicated or something that could have a larger impact, then you could actually have a human that is approving the communication of this kind of information. Okay, let's see another example. Let's say that the company is using an external AI system for processing data about its customers. So the risk could be here that this data is leaked if this data was used for a training of the large language model. So again, a couple of controls are possible here. So the first control might be that actually, instead of using an external large language model, a company can simply install internally on its own internal server a small language model which does the job but doesn't actually transfer any information outside of company's control. Or alternatively, if a company decides to use this large language model from an external party, then it needs to sign very clear terms and conditions that this data provided by the company cannot be used for training of this large language model. Further, in this case, a company can anonymize any information that is sent to a large language model so that actually no personal information can be identified. Or a company can decide that it doesn't send all of the records towards the large language models, only the records that are less sensitive, and therefore to decrease any potential impact if this information leaks. So what are the key points here? First of all, as you can see, these controls are never only IT related. They are always a combination of IT and legal and I would say business or management controls. And the second point is I've provided you only with two examples with two potential risks. Now there can be numerous risks for each AI system that is being used, and then it becomes very complex to manage all of these things, so many risks, so many controls and so on. And this is why ISO 42001 is very useful, because it provides you a systematic way to manage all of these numerous risks, all of these numerous controls, because it has these clauses on how you actually manage such a system. And it also has this catalog of controls in the Annex A, where you can actually choose the controls that are the most appropriate for your particular case. Okay, let me now show you where you can learn more about the basics of this standard. Okay, I'm showing you now this ISO 42001 Foundations online course from Advisera. Here you can find some general information about the course. And here you can actually see that you can sign up for the course completely free. You can go through all of these lessons without any payments. And if you need to go for the exam and certification, then you would need to pay a fee. Now let's focus here on the curriculum. So let's see what kind of lessons are included. So in module one, you'll find lots of useful lessons. Okay, this one is more general, very similar to this YouTube video, but here you'll find more information about the structure, general objectives that are suggested in Annex C. Then you have this introduction to the AIMS, also how to implement it according to this plan to check and act cycle, how to implement it as a project, how you document the AIMS, what are the benefits, what are related standards and regulations, some explanation of basic AI terminology, and then into more depth about machine learning, different types of machine learning, neural networks, what are the main components of an AI system, what is this AI system lifecycle, and some questions about certification. Let's briefly see other modules. So module 2 starts to focus on clause 4 and then clause 5 and clause 7. So basically this is where the course starts to go into the details of each and every clause. Same for module 3. So basically here everything is around clause number 6. So risk assessment, treatment, statement of applicability, objectives, planning of changes. And then module number 4 is about clause 8 operation. You can see all the details here. Module 5 is about monitoring, review and improvement. So these are clauses 9 and 10. And finally, module number 6, so this is about annexes A and B, where all the AI controls are explained basically from all the subsections here. Okay, I hope this was helpful, and let me know in the comments below if you have any questions about ISO 42001, and I'll answer as quick as I can. And if you want to access this ISO 42001 Foundations course that I was showing you, click the link in the description below and you'll be able to sign up for a free account for this course. You'll be able to go through all of the videos for free. And as I mentioned, we charge only if you go for the certification exam. And see also my next video, which goes into the details of what each clause and control from ISO 42001 prescribes. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel not to miss any of my new videos. And I publish videos about AI governance and cybersecurity governance every week. Thanks for watching.